All right, good morning. This is breakfast at the Giovanni Caravelle.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
You have friends you want to say hi to?
Too many of them.
Okay. So here's our breakfast here. All kinds of breads there and jams and jellies and cereals and fruits and meats and eggs. And more over there. Look at that. So this is our first breakfast here all together.
Winner.
Yeah. Morning, Father.
Morning.
Island of Pelops, therefore, because southern Greece gives the impression of an island, is a peninsula, especially when it was cut at the Corinth Canal, else called Isthmus, and this will happen the end of the 19th century. We will elaborate about this later on. So this is a small introduction. I will...
All right, we're disembarking off the red bus and the blue bus, our two groups. And there is Ross Hoffman having way too much fun. And we just got off at Corinth, and look at there, that is the Temple of Apollo. We're gonna be viewing that in just a little bit. We're gonna start with Mass first.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
He was born Saul of Tarsus, born in Cilicia some 2,000 years ago, but he had that dramatic conversion experience where he encountered the risen Lord. And from that point on, he left behind his old identity of Saul, and he became Paul. We call him an apostle. An apostle because we know apostles are those who had two characteristics. First, they witnessed the risen Christ, and secondly, they were sent. Apostolo in Greek means to be sent, one who is sent forth.
They all seized Sosthenes, the synagogue official. Now, obviously, Sosthenes was one who had become a believer in Paul's words. This all happened right in front of there. Can you believe it? I said, you know, how many times I've been here, I still get excited about this. They all seized Sosthenes, the synagogue official, and they beat him up in full view of the tribunal. But none of this was any concern to him. Paul remained for quite some time, and after saying farewell to the brothers, he sailed away for Syria. That's just one of the episodes that took place here. And the reason I wanted to read it is because we're having Mass right in front of that the tribunal, or it's called the Bema, or the judgment seat, where it took place. By the way, in Cenchrea, Paul got a haircut there one time. Says he had his hair cut because he was making a vow. But this road, the Lechian Road, and another road coming this way, met here. And if you wanted to know what was going on, all the travelers would come in and they'd stop and they would announce the news of what's going on in Patra and in Rome and everywhere else. So this was the center of town. This was the town square. You'd learned everything about what was going on everywhere right here. You say, oh, that's St. Paul right there. We have a description of what he looked like, and it's very much in harmony with the earliest icons that we have of him. And it was written in a document called Paul and Thecla. It said he was very short. My guess, he was about 5 feet tall. Because back then, men were about 5'4", women were about 5', because they were shorter than we are. And so here's this little short guy coming in. They also said that he had the same kind of hairstyle as I had. My dad told me, Steve, when you grow up, just remember, God only created a few perfect heads and the rest he covered with hair. So let this hair. But it said that Paul was a bald-headed man. He had, like all the Jews, he had a long pointed beard. His was long and pointed. The Romans were the ones who scraped their faces. The Jews were proud of their beards. It says that he had bow-legged. He rode a horse too much. So he was bow-legged or knobby-kneed. It's not clear whether it's bow-legged or where he kind of knocks his knees when he walks. But you'd have seen this guy coming along. It said he had a large hooked nose. And then the one I like the best, it says he only had one eyebrow. And it wasn't a left or the right, it was one big one all the way across. Called a unibrow. And he says his eyebrows met in the middle. And it said that sometimes he had the face of a man and sometimes the face of an angel. This is how you would have known him coming along, dressed probably in very dirty sandals, worn out, because this man walked 6,000 miles in his lifetime that we guess. The canal here in Corinth that's been dug through the isthmus, and there's a ship coming through being pulled by a tug. This is looking out our hotel window here in Patras, Greece. It's in the Penelopes, what used to be Achaia. And this is where the Battle of Lepanto was fought, believe it or not. Right here in this bay, the Bay of Patras. And right near here is also where St. Andrew, the brother of Peter, was hung on a cross. We all know it as the X-shaped cross.